you know, normally with me, you get the class setup at the end of my video. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Darktail the Wise, aka Daddy Daycare. I'm over here at Noob Sweaty Gaming. And what we got here is a little gameplay on Terminal Team Tactical Deathmatch, which actually gives Terminal a better, more nostalgic feel, like how it used to feel. I'm on with the infamous Mr. Delta Elite. And first and foremost, I just wanted to say for the channel in general is that I got some things in the works, couple things brewing. So if you're not following me on social media, be sure to follow me on Twitter. But I also have an Instagram. You can follow me there as well. But I try to keep everybody up to date and posted on the latest with Noob to Sweaty Gaming. So I have a charity event I'm in the works of planning to get done. You know, I've mentioned it a couple times before, but it is coming. So be on the lookout for that. Getting excited. And hopefully everything that I got in the works is gonna be beneficial to myself, beneficial to the content, and hopefully everyone will enjoy it. So now that kind of cleared up that mess, I'm just curious, what is Infinity Ward doing? I mean, what is their deal? We are pushing February, and we're gonna get the first DLC. Well, at least y'all will be getting the first DLC for this game. I have not purchased the season pass for this game. It is the first COD that I have not purchased this season pass for. And I've seen a couple videos out there, and it's true, especially in the movie industry. How do you show that you don't support what is going on? You show it by not spending your money. So for me personally, I wouldn't pay $15 for a DLC, let alone whatever it is, $30 for a season pass for any content with this game. It's like everything is a tester. Oh wait, here, we got boots on the ground for you. We're finally going to give you what you want. Tactical TDM. But it's only for a limited time. So they get the people to fill the lobbies a bit. And then when they see that it's going over well, oh no, that's going to be part of the game from now on. But let alone you haven't done anything else with anything else. I mean, we still don't have the after action report. We still don't have custom emblems. And I've been told, well, what's a custom emblem? I mean, who cares about that? Hey, that's a way to promote your channel. You know, that's a way for you to personally promote yourself. Some people take it to do some stupid stuff or to be a smartass. I mean, there's those people in the world. But for me personally, my custom emblem is to say, hey, here's Noob to Sweaty Gaming. Go check out my channel. So, leaderboards come, they're broken. They still got 600 camos and another 100 guns to add. Hey, but are they ever concerned about completing this game? No. They're trying to squeeze every cent, every dollar out. And personally, I've had a lot of fun with Boots on the Ground, Infinite Warfare, Tactical TDM, but it's not the saving grace of this game. And some of the things that I'm experiencing, I know people in my area are also experiencing. And at this point of Black Ops 3 life cycle, the game was very enjoyable to me. I still wasn't any good at it. As I go ahead and pick up that warden, we're getting to the end of this match, but I wasn't good at Black Ops 3 yet. However, I still was enjoying the content. I was still enjoying the game. And they fudged that game up with a bunch of, you know, outfits and costumes and color schemes and everything as well. But just not to the extent that Infinity Ward is putting this stuff out, even if it's on behalf of Activision, trying to kill COD in one game cycle. And I'm not putting any of my money into this. Let me know how you feel down in the comments section. You're never too old to live, and I will be seeing you guys on the next one.